When does silence come? When you listen for it, silence will bless you. Silence will steal your heart. The silence that cannot be heard will fill your ears. The silence will fill your whole bloodstream. The silence will be home to you. Your heart will be compelled by it. Compelled to what? Your heart will be compelled to give way to this silence. The silence simply overtakes, and you know oneness. It is overflowing. It takes your residue of smallness and fills you to the brim with oneness. You do not think oneness. You are oneness. This silence is like a flute from which all notes come. The silence we speak of is music that overcomes you. All that you thought you were disappears. You hear nothing but myself. You are nothing but myself. You are truly out of this world of right or wrong, good or bad. You are out of this world. There are no questions. There is essence, and you are the essence. There is nothing but you, the you that is I, that is. You are at the source. You are the source. You are what you have been seeking all along. You no longer seek that which is at your disposal because now you know wherein I reside. The source, your true self, has always been at your disposal. It isn't that you are an alchemist who can turn tin into gold. Tin never was. Gold never went away. Diamonds are diamonds whether you are aware they are diamonds or not. What I speak of is not a conscious decision. You cannot make a decision to be oneness. Beloveds, you yourself and I are the decision. This is what you have been waiting for and anguishing for, oneness that has always been right in the palm of your hand. When you are allness, there are no questions. There are no quests. You abide in the heart of oneness where oneness alone is. You aren't in the water. You are the fount of the water. This has nothing to do with ego. Ego isn't capable of entering the silence. Ego has to have horns and whistles. Silence is. Silence is everything and requires nothing. Wholeness is wholeness. It cannot be broken into pieces, or it is not wholeness. Silence is not exactly a meeting place, for we have always been met. There isn't newness here. There is what has always been. What you yearn for is yourself. It may seem that yourself has been outside you all along. Yourself has always been within you. It is as if you were too busy, and the world was too noisy. You did not know how to take a break from the world, nor did you want to break with the world, for the world provides you with one kind of adventure. Silence doesn't take away from you. It does take away your ignorance and restores you to innocence. It is not even that you dwell on this and figure it out. When the sun shines, you know what sunshine is. There is no figuring or configuring. There are no details. There is no rising, for you are risen. There is nowhere to go and no time to do it in. Is it possible for you to move in the world and stay in the silence? Yes, it is. This is the reality, yet your cognizance has not yet quite absorbed this. So it happens that you are often at odds with yourself. You are never at odds with me, no matter how much you may think you are. If you are at odds, it is yourself that you are at odds with. All arguments, regardless of how they may appear in the world, are with yourself. The enemy you perceive out there is yourself. You are free to continue fighting, just as you are free to accept the non-ego magnificence that is the truth of you. All this, you have not recognized or realized. We are talking about self-realization. It is the most non-ego thing you ever thought of. Ego was never real. Oneness is.